friends, warm greetings from Eklavya Academy. If you like my videos, please share, subscribe, like and comment the channel. Today we are going to see the expected questions in UNIX programming in NTA NET December 2018. Question 1. The unlinked system call is used in UNIX as unlink of path name. Which of the following statements are always true? Statement 1. The file is no more accessible. Statement 2. The call removes inode entry for that file. Statement 3. The call removes directory entry for that file. Statement 4. The call releases blocks allocated to the file. Option A 1, 2, 3. Option B 1, 2, 4. Option C 3. Option D 1, 3. The correct answer is option C 3. Question 2. Which one of the following UNIX commands can list the symbols defined in a library or ELF executable? Option A ID, option B NM, option C strip, option D DU. The correct answer is option B NM. The usage of NM command is, it provides the information on the symbols being used in object file or executable file. Question 3. Which of the following sections of an executable binary file on UNIX has all uninitialized data items? Option A .bss section, option B .data section, option C .ro data section, option D .text section. The correct answer is option A .bss section. Question 4. The read system call returns option A total number of bytes, option B file descriptor of the file, option C successful read flag, option D address of the file. The correct answer is option A total number of bytes. Read system can take three arguments. First one is file descriptor of the file. Second one is buffer where the read data is to be stored. Third one, number of bytes to be read from the file. But it returns the value of output is the number of bytes read only. So the option A is the correct one. Question 5. The following is the source code corresponding to a bash shell. S1.sh in UNIX system. For I in $star do cat $i done. What will be the output if S1.sh is executed from the console? $sh S1.sh star. Option A displays contents of the file labeled as star. Option B displays list of all the files in present working directory. Option C displays contents of all the files in present working directory. Option D displays error message. The correct answer is C, displays contents of all the files in present working directory. Here in the shell script cat $i, the usage of cat command is to display the content of the file. Then in the statement s1.sh is the script name. Here star indicates the input argument. Star means all the files. So it displays the contents of all the files in present working directory. Question 6. The touch command on UNIX system. Option A. Creates a new file without opening it. Option B. Creates a new file after opening it. Option C. Creates a new file by opening and closing it immediately. Option D. Creates a new file by renaming old file. The correct answer is option A. Creates a new file without opening it. Because touch command avoids opening, saving and closing of file. Question 7. The following is the source code corresponding to a bash shell script s1.sh in UNIX system. Echo $0, $#, $*, $1, $2. What will be the output if s1.sh is executed from the console as follows? $sh, s1.sh, sh, s1.sh. Option A, s1.sh, 2, sh, s1.sh. Option B, s1.sh, 2, sh, s1.sh, sh. Option C, s1.sh, 2, sh, s1.sh, sh, s1.sh. Option D, displays error message. See the shell script echo $0. $0 means it is the name of the shell program. S1.sh is the name of the shell program. So it returns s1.sh. $ash means number of command line arguments. Here sh, s1.sh, these two are arguments. So it returns number 2. $* means it merges the arguments into single argument. Actually sh, s1.sh is the arguments. It merges these two arguments in as a single argument. Then $1. $1 returns the first argument. Here sh is the first argument. $2 returns the second argument. Here s1.sh is the second argument. The final answer looks like this: s1.sh to sh, s1.sh, sh, s1.sh. So the correct answer is option C. Question 8. In UNIX, the command $chmod664 file represent option A, user and group read and write, others write only. Option B, user and group read and write, others read only. Option C, user and group read, others read only. Option D, user and group write, others write only. The correct answer is option B. Let's see how. Read 4, write 2, execute 1. Here the actual number is 664. It represent user, it represent group, it represent others. The user having the permission read and write. Group also having the permission read and write, but others having the permission read only. So the option B is the right one. Question 9. In a UNIX file system, dot and double dot represents option A, parent, comma, current. Option B, parent, comma, parent. Option C, current, comma, parent. Option D, current, comma, current. The correct answer is option C, current, comma, parent. Question 10. The process state transition diagram for a UNIX-like uniprocess system is given below. Which transitions are not possible? Option A, A, D, G, F. Option B, C, H, F. Option C, A, C, H, F. Option D, C, G, E. The correct answer is option B, C, H, F. How? First, we should know the working principle of process state transition diagram. A process after creation is not immediately put into the ready state. Instead, it is put into the created state. Then it can move to the ready to run in memory or ready to run in swapped state based on the available memory. When it arrives in memory, based on the scheduling, we move to the kernel mode or user mode as per the requirements. Interrupts in between will send the system into the sleep state. When the process finishes execution, it invokes the exit system call and goes into the zombie state. This is the working principle of process state transition diagram. See this diagram. In the diagram, the transition C moves to the kernel running. It is not allowable because a process in the sleeping state cannot move to the kernel mode directly. It must be wake up and goes into the ready to run state, then only it can move to the kernel running state. Then the process H from the state ready to run a process does not go into the sleeping state. A process should go to the sleeping state from the kernel running state only. So it is not allowable. Then the transition F. While the system call an interrupt in between, the kernel should send the process to sleep state only, not to the ready to run state. So these three transitions are not allowable.